Hello everyone! Welcome back! You are learning English with Puandiana Azmin. This is English Year 4. In this lesson, we are going to learn Module 8 Amazing Animals. Let's start. What are we going to learn today? We are going to learn the comparative adjectives. Now, what is comparative adjectives? Let's take a look at the next slide. How much do you know about animals? Do this quiz and find out. Are you animal expert or not? Question number one. Which is bigger? A. A gorilla. B. A monkey. So which one is bigger? Yes, of course, a gorilla. Very good. Question number two. Which elephant has got smaller ears? Is it A, the African elephant? Or B, the Asian elephant? And your answer is B, the Asian elephant. So it is this one. Question number three. Which camel has got more humps? Is it A, the Arabian, or B, the Bactrian? Your answer is? Yes, it is B, the Bactrian. Question number four. Which is heavier? A, the panda, or B, the polar bear? So the answer is? Yes, B, the polar bear. Question number five. Which is faster? Is it A, a tortoise, or B, a snail? And the answer is yes, A, a tortoise. And last question, which is stronger? Is it A, a rhino, or B, a hippo? And the answer is yes, A, a rhino. Well done, kids. You have got it all correct. In this lesson, you are going to learn the value of know about the animal kingdom. Now, take a look at this picture. We have two monkeys in the picture. The big monkey says, "Look, Toto, I'm stronger than you." The small monkey replies, "Yes, but I am more intelligent and thinner than you, Jojo." Now, what is comparative adjective? Now, we use comparative form to compare two people, or two animals, or two things. Like in this picture, we are comparing between the big monkey and the small monkey. So, when we are comparing two people, two animals, or two things, we are going to use comparative form sentences. Okay? So, the adjectives in the comparative form is usually followed by the word then. Now, let's take a look at this example. Look, Toto, I'm stronger than you. So, the word then is to compare between this monkey and this monkey. So which one is stronger? This monkey is stronger. Okay? And this one? But I am more intelligent and thinner than you, Jojo. So it's to compare between this monkey, Toto, and this monkey, Jojo. Okay? So Jojo is stronger, but Toto is much more thinner and intelligent. Let's take a look at this example. So in comparative adjectives, we have a few rules. Okay, for one syllable word, what is one syllable? We know what is word, but do we know what is the meaning of syllable? Okay, kids, syllable is actually the sound of the word. Okay, when you see one sound word or one syllable word. For example, tall. Light, also one sound. Light, one sound. Cheap. Cheap is also one sound. And last one, cold. Cold. Cold also has one syllable. So when you see all this one sound or one syllable word, what do you need to do to the word? You need to add ER. Look at the example. Tall. When you add ER to the word tall, it will change to taller. Taller. Light. Add ER, it will become lighter. Lighter. Cheap. What will cheap becomes when you put ER at the word cheap? It will become cheaper. Yes, cheaper. Cold. When you put ER to the word cold, it will become colder. Okay? Colder. Alright, kids. Next, there are some adjective words that will end with E. You need to add R. For example, the word large. Look at the last letter. The last letter is E. Large. Wise. Again, the last letter is E. Another one, strange. So when you see the adjectives that end with E, you need to add R. So large, when you add R, it will become larger. Wise, it will become, yes, wiser. And strange, strange will become stranger. So these are some of the adjectives which end with E that you need to add R. Adjectives which end in one vowel plus one consonant, what do? We need to double the consonant and add ER. Okay, don't get it confused. Now, understand this word first. What is the meaning of vowel? Now, vowel is actually A, E, I, O, U. So these are vowels. But what is consonant? So consonant are others alphabet which does not contain A, E, I, O, U. So the alphabets like B, C, D, F, G, H, and so on, these are called consonant. Okay, let's take a look at the example. The word big. You see, we have B, I, G. So I is a vowel and G is a consonant. Big. The word fat. Again, we have one vowel, one consonant. Remember, the rule must be the vowel first. So one vowel, one consonant. And thin, one vowel, one consonant. Okay? So when you see the word that ends with one vowel, one consonant, what does the rule say? You need to double the consonant before you add ER. So the word big, which one is the consonant? The last one is G. So we need to double the G and then we add ER. So it will become bigger. Alright? Bigger. So B-I-G is the original word. Okay? And then you double the consonant. So you have to double the G before you add ER. So it will become bigger. Now you try fat. One vowel, one consonant. So which one must you double? Yes, you have to double the T before you add ER. So it will become fatter. F-A-T-T-E-R. Fatter. Okay, the last word is thin. So we have the vowel I and the consonant N. So the last consonant is N. So T-H-I-N, double the N, and then plus E-R becomes thinner. Adjectives ending with consonant Y, what must we do to the consonant Y? You need to change Y to I and add ER. Let's take a look at the adjective that ends with Y. The first one is happy, so the last letter is Y. Pretty, P-R-E-T-T-Y. Again, the last letter is Y. And last one is tidy, T-I-D-Y. So again, the last letter is Y. So look at the example. Happy. Change Y to I. It will become happier. So H-A-P-P. The Y is gone. But then we replace it with I. And then we plus E-R. So it will become happier. Okay, look at number two. Pretty. So pretty will become prettier. Now, the word tidy. So the word tidy, what do we do? Again, we have to take out the Y and change to I. And then we have to plus ER. Tidier. Tidier. Okay, next. Three or more syllables adjective. Okay, it means word that has three sounds. Okay, we need to plus the word more and then the word adjective itself. Let me show you the example. Okay, like the word expensive. Okay, how many syllable? Expensive. So there are three syllables here. Three sounds. Expensive. Three sound word. Three syllables. Okay, next word. Comfortable. So this one has four sounds. Okay, next word we have intelligent. So this one also we have four syllables. It means more than three. And last word we have beautiful. Beautiful. So again, there are three sounds in this word. The word expensive. So what do we do to the word? We need to add more. What will becomes more expensive? See, we add the word more, but we maintain the original word, expensive. We did not change. Okay, next word, comfortable. So comfortable has four syllables. So what do? We add the word more and then the word itself. So more comfortable. Okay, so for the word intelligent, we are going to apply the same rules. We add the word more and then maintain the word intelligent. So we have more intelligent. And the last word, beautiful. So beautiful has three syllables. Again, we add the word more and then we add the adjective itself. So more beautiful. Okay, so these are the rules for the word that has three or more syllables adjective. Alright, so the last one. Some adjectives are irregular and do not apply the same rules as the regular adjectives. So, for example, the word good, the word bad, the word far, and the word many or much. Now, this word, they don't follow the normal rules. For example, the word good. Now, what did I say earlier? For the one syllable word, we need to add ER. So, for this one, gooder. Gooder is wrong. We don't have gooder. So this is what we call irregular. Means we don't follow the same rules. Okay, bad. Bad, if we follow the rules, we have the vowel and consonant. So the rules say for vowel and consonant, you need to double the D. But for this word, this is irregular. Okay, when it is irregular, you cannot double the consonant and plus ER. So it is not better, okay, because we don't have such word. And the word far, this word, we cannot apply the same rules. So it is not farer. And last one, the word many and much. Now, the rule said for the word that ends with Y, you need to change to I. But for this one, we cannot change to I. And we also cannot add ER because this is irregular adjective. Okay, so it is not manier and it is not matcher. So what do we do? Okay, so for the irregular adjective, we cannot apply the same rules. So what do we do? So the word good, when you want to compare, it will become better. For example, Ali is better than Abu in drawing. Okay, we don't say Ali is gooder than Abu in drawing. All right, for the word bad, we cannot write better. Bad, when you want to compare, it will become worse. Worse. Okay, far, it is not farer, but it is farther or further. Okay, and the word many and much, okay, it's not manier and it's not matcher, but you need to change it to more. All right. Alright everyone, that's all for today's lesson. You may try out these exercises and see how many you can get it correct. If you need to check your answers, you may click on the information box below. Alright everyone, that's all for today's lesson. Till we meet again next time. See you again. Bye bye.